Welcome back. Today we shall introduce a new method through which you can generate publication-ready Nova tables within few simple steps. You can export this table in MS Word, PDF and HTML document. What I know, none of the software can generate such table if you do not have advanced knowledge of the corresponding programming language. This will help researchers to quickly create Nova tables while saving time by eliminating the need to manually input each command. This has significant benefit over typical manual procedures for computation and table display, which are not only time consuming, but also prone to errors. So let's get started. The packages that must be loaded before utilizing certain functions are listed here. I'll load these packages by using library function. Let's have a look at the dataset. The first variable in the dataset specifies the number of replications. And the following two are factor variables, and the remaining variables are response variables. To assess the relevance of treatments, we will use a two-factor randomized complete block design model. To import the dataset, we shall first locate the data file by using path parameter. When the column names parameter is set to true, the first row of the dataset will be used as a variable names. The elements of the data file will be stored in R as an object data. After applying str function to the object data, we can notice the R is reading the factor variables as character variables. We can use as.factor function to convert these variables to factors. If you apply str function again, then you can notice the variables are being read as factors in R. Now apply attach function to object data to mask its components. The difficult part comes next, as we shall build a for loop function that will ask for numerous parameters, and once answered will generate a publication ready Nova table for all of the response variables in the dataset. To begin, we shall need to build an object that should contain the column names for all of the response variables. The first response variable in this dataset is in the fourth column. As a result, the values for response variables will be assigned from fourth to the nth number of columns in the dataset. The analysis of variance model will be implemented with the help of lapply function, which returns a list that has the same length as x containing column names for the for all of the response variables. The next step is to define the ANOVA model. The model in the term labels argument is the component of the ANOVA model, which we use to print on the right side following the tilde. And depending on the experimental design, you may provide different model terms. You can print analysis of variance model from the list by using ANOVA function for respective variable. For example, typing 2 in double square brackets will print second ANOVA table from the list. We don't need all of the columns from this ANOVA table, so I'm going to choose the first, third, and fifth columns in the ANOVA table to represent degrees of freedom, mean square, and probability value respectively. If you wish to print the F value column instead of mean square, you can use 4 instead of 3. We also need to create an object that should specify row names, which will later be used to label the ANOVA table for sources of variation column. Redefine the column names for the ANOVA table that match to the columns we have already chosen. You can round values to required digits for ANOVA tables, as I shall round values to 2 decimal places, and then save the output as data frame. Instead of adding p-value column for each parameter, we shall use single asterisk, double asterisk, and ns to indicate significant, highly significant, and non-significant impacts. After that, we shall combine the column containing mean square values and the column where we just assign symbols, and these two columns will be merged by using paste function. We shall delete the extra column from ANOVA table using subtraction sign before concatenate function. The next challenging aspect was to print this final object containing list of NOVA tables, which if printed directly resulted in a single variable output instead of list of all variables. So I decided to first write this object in Excel sheet separately for each variable by using write Excel function. I specified path argument by pasting column names of each variable plus the additional text dash NOVA with the extension XLSX. This will write an NOVA table from the list of NOVA tables separately for each variable in Excel sheets. By doing this, I was able to read these Excel files to finally print publication ready NOVA table. What I did, I created an object file .list that will contain list of all files with the name dash NOVA and with the extension .xlsx. Then I used the lapply function to read this list by specifying function argument as read underscore Excel. In the following stage, I used the list.cbind function to join all of the previously generated lists. This combined NOVA table contains DF and MS column for all response variables in the dataset. However, the DF column was duplicated for each variable, which we need to remove. In the following command, I created an object containing names of duplicated columns and subsequently deleted duplicated columns by using subtraction sign before this object. In the final stage, we just need to add row names specifying the sources of variation in an NOVA table. As I have finished my code, so I need to write a for loop function to repeat it for all of the response variables in the dataset. This may be accomplished by enclosing all of the preceding instructions in the for loop function, which I have specified a range for I in 1 to n columns of the dataset, except first three variables. Finally, I have to print this table in MS Word document. To do so, we shall utilize the FlexTable function from the FlexTable package. We will supply the AOV.table object in the data parameter, and we may also give the column name for the table's row names following the pipe operator. By using the part parameter as header in the bold function, you may bold the column names. Click the compile report icon to produce this table in several document formats. You may choose any of the given document types. I'm going to choose MS Word document. This is how the NOVA table will appear in the end. Do you believe it's a matter of few clicks to produce a publication ready NOVA table in R after such tedious work? The answer is yes. You can get the same output by just altering few parameters for your own data. What you have to do is to provide the names of factor variables from your dataset at the beginning part when we transformed variables from character to factor. Then you need to select a model term that best describes the experimental design. Another thing that you have to alter is selecting the appropriate range of column names that may differ in your dataset. That's all. You can also download our script from the blog post, and its link is given in the description of this video. In comment section, you can tell me if you have any issues while using this script. I shall be happy to help you out. Thank you for your support to Agron Infotech. See you in the next lecture.